Welcome to the Fan Zone, episode 418. It's like, hold on. It's
okay,
the start
we could
of the
do
show.
That, but do my podcast. No.
That's how we doing it. I'm playing Tomb Raider.
Yeah. Go ahead, Kuro.
It's July 10th, 2016, and we are an adult podcast where shit happens right in the middle of the beginning. And we weren't going to do one today, but so much shit got leaked, and news came out that it was impossible for us not to do one.
Yeah.
Trying right, to get somebody else on here.
Hey Magnum, what time is the game tonight?
I don't even know. Is it not 9? I'm guessing it's 9.
Oh, damn.
It's like... So, we'll start off with our normal, what have you been playing? Why don't we start off with Damien, since he plays very little.
Oh, he has very little.
He ain't a real game.
Bejeweled. and Destiny. Yeah, I know. Getting ready for the new expansion.
A new expansion.
What are they adding in the new expansion? Let's just talk about it now, Sam.
It's supposed to be it's supposed to be the biggest expansion yet. It's supposed to be on Earth. It's called, the Iron, Rise of Iron or something.
Yeah.
So it's supposed, they're bringing back the Galahorn, that's one thing.
Now, I see that they're bringing it
and
back.
It's supposed to have a new raid included, even though I haven't done the old raid yet. But I haven't done the last raid.
Hey,
huh? What are you asking? No, I didn't hear you. What did you say?
No, never mind. Cause this shit lagging. It seems like. Go ahead.
Nah, my thing is good. My thing is good, right, Kuro?
It's better than it usually is.
That's not what I asked you, nigga.
except for that, I am a Caucasian.
Yeah, except for that part.
Yeah,
but not continue. My bad. Go ahead. I'll let you go ahead. Okay.
Yeah, so that's it. That's all I've been playing.
Yo, but do you know what they're adding to it?
No, we're going to get the details at E3.
Okay. So they season the seas?
Yeah, something like that.
Well, all right, since he's done. And Koala jerking off.
I'm not jerking off. I'm waiting.
I'm playing too. See how defensive you got? I'm not jerking off.
I'm not jerking off. Fucking shit, man.
Nah, but I'm playing Tomb Raider right now. Been playing that. No, I haven't been playing that. I played that. I went to work last week. Try to finish that. Overwatch. A lot of Overwatch.
I've been playing Overwatch
all week, bro. I ain't playing anything else for Overwatch.
You haven't even played your mainstays?
I played FIFA a little bit. I played like 3 matches of FIFA. So that was about
it is as good as the reviews are giving it?
For me, yeah. Man, it's first-person smash. Right, it's a first-person shooter smash. That's how it fucking equated. Like, team-based. Objective game. It's no fucking team deathmatch or something like that. It's capture a point. Each character is very unique.
Dude, I can barely hear. I could barely hear you, dude.
I've got him turned all the way up.
Well, you can hear him good?
Yeah, I turned him all the way up, so I can hear him.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, you're better.
So it's a first-person shooter. It's like Smash. It's, that's how I played it. The character's very unique. Every character plays a different way. No two characters play the same way. Kind of play alike, some of them. For the most part, they're unique. It's subjective fate, so no team deathmatch, nothing like that. Pretty much, you know, capture the point and moving a payload throughout the town for the most part. That's what you're doing. What else? I think that was it.
This list, we take a look at the most epic E3 moments of.
Fantastic, no. Much before. Oh, some Fallout.
Awesome Fallout. So, I've been playing a shit ton of Neverwinter. A lot. Like as much as he's been playing Overwatch, I've been playing Neverwinter. I've been playing some Fallout. That's just today, though. Uncharted. I beat Uncharted 1. I'll start Uncharted 2.
What did you think of it of the end?
Bad. Uncharted 1 was bad to today's standards. Like when it was released, it would have been good, but for today's standards, it was really bad.
Explanation.
The gameplay. It's actually like my second best Uncharted.
So the gameplay was so bad. Like, I don't know if they do it. I haven't run into it yet in Uncharted 2, where they pan out into, like, horrible fucking viewing angles for you to make a jump. So much bad viewing angles for a jump. And they force you. And so what I had to do is use the thing where you can slip into a first-person view to line myself up so that I knew I was lined up. To fucking make a jump.
You know they added that after.
Yeah, so I can't imagine how
that wasn't part of the original game.
Well, first
where you could do the first person view.
I didn't need that. I didn't have any time to get that far in person.
Dude, I fucking missed the jump so many times. Until someone told me.
I think Quell just left.
No, it's so fucking bad. Go back and play that shit, dude.
Nah, trust me. I know. I remember. I know what part that I remember that bothered me though, that submarine part.
Oh my god! Get on that one pipe to go across.
Yeah, exactly.
Holy
shit,
dude!
That little area was
so bad,
horrible.
And I was like, oh, I can go first person and look at it and make sure I'm lined up. There's another one where, you know, you had to swing over to one side, pull a lever. And then climb around. It was like somewhere in the middle of the game where you're going up. It's in a tower, like a round tower area, and you had to pull a lever, and you had to jump over and swing around. And there were like tiny little ledges you had to fucking jump on, like with your feet, and not swing on with your hands, which is pretty easy. And I would try and swing over and make the jump, and he would always go to his left instead of hugging the wall with his jump. And it fucking, like, 8 times in a row, dude, I got so fucking mad. You can go on YouTube and see how horrible I played that game. Like, there were parts in that game I got really frustrated with the fucking
jumping mechanic. You just said person that pissed me off when I watch you play. Like, man, just do this.
The first game did have problems, but
well, I was thinking, I was, hey, I, was when I look back, one. Right? So when I'm playing it, right, I'm thinking about how good Tomb Raider is, the current Tomb Raiders are, and how good fucking a lot of games' jumping mechanics are. And I think back to when this game launched, and it's not that bad for its time frame, right? It's actually really good. There's some annoying shit, like the panning way the fuck out for a jump. That shit pisses me off. But for most part, I can understand why people loved it. Like, it was groundbreaking. It wasn't. It didn't feel groundbreaking.
Yeah,
but for the time, it was groundbreaking. And then I get into 2, and the minute I started fucking moving in 2, I was like, oh my fucking god, so much better.
You fixed it.
So much better. It feels so much better moving around in 2. The only thing I didn't like about 2 is they changed something about the fucking pistol. I'm not sure what it is, but it doesn't feel the same.
The aim, the gun mechanics in all of those games are bad.
You're gonna hate
all of them.
3 is the worst.
What?
3 is the worst.
3 is the worst.
The gun mechanics are bad.
I don't know if they updated, but it has the delay.
I'm really enjoying 2, like the story. Like the story.
No, two is the best one.
Yeah, so 2 so far in 2.
But to be honest though, I kind of like the story in the first one better. In terms of the going after the El Diablo.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I kind
of
like that.
I mean, the City of Gold.
Yeah.
And the whole thing with the statue.
Yeah, hey, it's been fucking almost 10 years.
Second one.
So yeah, the statue turned
on
all the zombies.
I don't like what they did, but you haven't played the second one yet, right?
I'm about 2 hours.
No, when I said the second one, I didn't like that whole thing. Like, they went to this garden.
Hey, goddamn it!
Give this guy supernatural
powers. I'm only 2 hours in it.
Yeah, but you say you played it already, so I didn't want to spoil it.
I played the first game already. I played the first game.
Whoa, bro.
No fucking spoilers, dude. Jesus. I'm gonna call you out when I fucking do my stream.
That whole area. Well, you're gonna be playing this game, right? You're gonna play it. You're gonna enjoy it. You're gonna be like, okay. You'll see a lot of cool shit. You're like, okay, I'm not seeing this another game. And you're gonna think you're not gonna think the game's done. But you're gonna get to a point, you're gonna feel like, okay, this game is done. And then you're gonna go somewhere and you're gonna be like, what the fuck? Where am I? Like, you're gonna be in this place. It's so mystical.
Shambhala.
I think that's the proper word. That type of shit, yeah.
Yep.
Like the place you visit when you were in Far Cry 4.
That type of shit, yeah. But on an Uncharted level, that shit is crazy. Like, I really love that game. That's the best one. I ain't tried 4.
It is.
I heard 4 is slow, so.
Everybody says 2 is still better than 4. So, I got 4. Thank you. I want to thank somebody. Hold on, let me... I gotta open up Twitter because I can't fucking remember his name. But he fucking sent me a copy of Uncharted 4.
Oh, what?
Fucking for real, dude. He's like, I got something that you'll want. He's like, make sure you get it in the mail. And I got this little package. Hold on,
a physical copy?
Yeah, a physical copy. Or
digital copy.
What's it like to be in good hands? Like, having
yeah,
needs,
I'm not going
to
start getting on Twitter yet. I don't want to
like home.
Like, I keep my phone closed.
You're not on Twitter yet, Magnum?
No, I'll be on Twitter. I just I don't give a fuck.
It's good to be
here. That shit don't even cross my mind during the day.
Sorry about that.
Take a look at the most epic E3 moments of all time.
What the fuck?
So we hope your body is ready for some E3 hype.
No, I don't want to fucking see epic E3 moments. So, what the fuck were we talking about before I got interrupted by a caller that didn't want to reveal their fucking phone number?
You were saying that you received a physical copy of Uncharted through the mail.
You were saying how you're going to make those fans start giving us free games.
No.
My Twitter handle is Magnum28. Holla at me. I'm not going to respond, though, so I don't really send anything.
All right, so it was Killer Instinct. @Killer_Instinct. I don't want to spell it out. That's not exactly how it's spelled.
How dare you? I'm the only one here who plays Killer Instinct. You going to send him something?
It's with the E with an R underscore and then I N and an 8 instead of a I N S T I N 8. So, but he sent it to me, and I will be streaming it. I'm excited to fucking play it though. I thought I was gonna have to wait a while. So I thought I was gonna have to wait a while before I'd be able to get it, but he sent it to me. So as soon as I'm done with 3, I'll start streaming 4. So yeah, I'm about 2 hours
in.
Play it on the Neo. You think they'll have a patch for it?
Yeah. Yep. I'm sure they'll announce it at E3 too.
They said they weren't going to announce it at E3. We're going to see how this shit
No, I don't mean the Neo. I'm sure they're going to announce somewhere that there's a patch for Uncharted 4 for the Neo.
Because I think they're going to announce some DLC for Uncharted. Maybe they'll announce what the DLC will be, support for the next PlayStation or whatever the fuck they're going to call it. Because it looks like they're not going to announce it at E3. And if this... And I think... I couldn't hear because I was chatting with you guys. But you listened to that guy. Did he say that he heard that the PlayStation 4 wasn't going to release this year? The Neo?
Yeah, that's what he said.
So
if he says that and it doesn't release this year, this is a new gen.
That's exactly what it is.
Because he's hearing maybe spring.
If they don't release it this year, yeah.
Yeah, but here's the problem. Neither one of them are getting released this year, and they both know that neither one are getting released this year, neither one of them are going to say shit. I'm surprised Sony even acknowledged the fact that it's real. I think it's gotten so far.
They have to.
Like, everybody knows the specs and everything. If these two consoles launch together, that's a whole fucking another discussion that we should get into.
Uh-huh.
So Sony officially confirms, and this will be our first starting point, I guess, a nice segue. Sony officially confirms that the PlayStation Neo exists, as well as saying that it will not be at E3. What were his exact words? Because that's important. Will the Neo not be at E3, or will they not say anything about it at E3?
They're not going to mention it at E3. Well, no. His exact words... Let me pull up his exact words.
Magnum's right. 4 years is the best model.
They said, so I'm reading it. It's intended to sit. Oh, so here, High House said that the high end console won't be shown at this year's E3.
Right.
Right? So that doesn't mean they won't say anything about it, right? Like, if they're going to announce a big single player DLC, they won't say this will be compatible with our upgraded PlayStation that comes out sometime in the future. From the documents that leaked, the Neo starting in October, right? Game is released in October, it has to be patched to work with the Neo, and anytime after October, it has to work with the Neo. Isn't that right?
Right.
Yeah.
So, he's thinking spring. That means they don't have a lot of shows to launch that. So in August, the middle of August,
they got Gamescom. I think they're going to show it at Gamescom.
So
or remember they have their own show at the end of the year. When is this same Paris thing? In December?
I don't know. Gamescom's a better place to do it at. There's more people at Gamescom. Unless they want to keep it to, on the DL.
Yeah, and what Gamescom? Gamescom is what, in like 8 weeks?
August 15th, I think. 14th, 15th is when it starts. I just looked it up earlier today because I was talking about it. Gamescom 2016 is August 19th. No, that's not. That's not it. Yeah. That's the date it. That's the date it first started. August 19th, 2009. So, you know, it'd be really nice if Gamescom 7. Oh, I hate this. It's gonna be the 17th through the 21st of August. I have to turn my mind backwards to read European dates. I have to read it backwards. 2016, 08, which is the month.
Yeah, so
17th to 21st.
I don't know. You guys think they're gonna release that shit game time or announce it? Like they have.
I believe it's not known to that game.
It's spring. If it's
that's the best place.
If it's spring.
Cause you remember by then. All the stuff they want to talk about with the VR, they should have talked about. So, it's just to show that GamesCon. Remember, they won at GamesCon last year.
It kills me, though.
So, at least they'll come back with a splash.
If they announce it at GamesCon, they've got August, September, October. They got August, September to October, November.
Or they can
December.
Keep their own show.
And then what? When is it going to launch? Spring? So, they've got 9 months, right? I don't know if you just wait till the end of the year and announce it in February, like you announced the PlayStation 4.
Right.
Unless you
exactly keep their own show.
But I just don't. I don't know because everybody already knows. Everybody that's gonna, you know, all your early adopters already know about the Neo. Right.
Yeah.
It's everywhere.
But it's still. Is not gonna slow down.
It might slow the sales down a little bit, because if a mom goes up to GameStop and says, "Oh, I was thinking about getting a PlayStation 4 for little Johnny," right?
They're not gonna tell her wait.
No, they might be there's a PlayStation Neo coming out, and but then he needs something for Christmas, right?
They also gotta tell her it's gonna be more expensive because that's what how said in his thing. It's gonna be more expensive than the PS4.
I wonder how much more expensive.
You said you read it, right?
I read it.
It doesn't matter. It could be a dollar. It's more expensive.
Nah, he said it was gonna be so it's more expensive. How much is it?
Will cost PS4 more than $350.
Yeah, so that could be four.
It is intended here's what surprised me, though. It is intended to sit alongside and complement the standard PS4. We will be selling both through the life cycle. All games will support the standard PS4, and we anticipate all or very large majority of the games will also support the high-end PS4. So they're not requiring you to support the high-end PS4. That's interesting.
But now my question to you guys is this. Do you think this is the end of console generation cycles?
No.
So you think eventually we will see a PlayStation 5?
Eventually you're going to screw over this generation. Yes, we'll see one. But eventually you're going to screw over the generation. The gap is leap.
What? You petered out on us.
Oh, I did? Oh, yeah. My bad. I don't know. So they're going to appease whoever they're going to appease now. And then when it's time, they're just going to stop developing games for it. Like, it's just going to have to happen.
See, I think that... I think what's going to end up happening is that the PS4 and Xbox One will likely be supported well past their normal life cycle by like EA and Activision for their big, their bigger games. More EA because of sports. You know, a lot of people won't go out and buy a new console just to play fucking Madden and FIFA.
I think this is the end of traditional console cycles.
I think it is. I don't think it's like, the end
at least
like
for
big
Microsoft.
I think that's a whole different thing.
Well, look at it this way. Look at it this way. Yeah, but Cruel, look at it this way. If the specs on the Neo turn out to be so, that is a significant jump. You see what I'm saying?
Yes, that is a significant jump.
So that's what I'm saying. I think it's, that's what Microsoft would do. Like every 4 years, release a significant jump. You know, yeah, just release a significant jump, and that would be their new console.
Yeah, whatever. Whenever there's
and
tech,
you know what that does.
Price range.
So even when Sony released a PS5, the Xbox community will still be playing their games, and they'll be like, okay, well, don't worry, we'll get our update in the next 2 years. Yeah. You know, we'll get an upgrade in the next 2 years. So you know.
Well, there was the rumor.
And because if you guys notice, you don't have Microsoft calling it the Xbox One anymore. They just say Xbox.
I don't know. That's nothing.
It's not the Xbox One Scorpio. You know, it's just the Xbox Scorpio.
But I didn't hear them talk about the Scorpion at all. When did they talk about the Scorpion?
Oh well, Microsoft hasn't talked about it. You're right. But I don't think they even use the Xbox One name anymore. I think they just say Xbox.
I don't know. Sony basically announced to everybody that there's a new console coming. So they've already announced their console.
Yep.
I mean, it's low key, but they've announced their fucking console. I just don't know what's the point in not announcing it at E3 or fucking
who, Sony
or
Microsoft?
If you're not gonna either one of them. More Sony because they've already came out and confirmed that the thing exists. If you don't announce it at E3 and you announce it at Gamescom, you're essentially doing the same thing as if you had announced it at E3. There are going to be a group of players that might have.
I think E3 is going to be all about VR. E3 is going to be all about VR.
E3,
and that's why Sony conference going to stop.
I don't know, maybe they're trying to pull a territories move, VR in America, get that shit pumping, fucking, they're already big in Europe, so games
come in
Europe.
Sony is more looking to capitalize upon the American market now.
There's no way for that rumor to be true for them to have that shit, or have those games compatible by October for it not to come out, and there's no way that I could believe that they're going to introduce something into the PS4 family and not have it out at holiday. Like,
yeah, they're going to announce it this year, it's got to be out by holiday. If it's not out by holiday, you're killing your holiday sales. I mean, unless they got some big name that's coming out this holiday, they don't really have anything coming out holiday as far as we know, right?
The Last Guardian.
No, there's a lot of rumors. There's rumors that Detroit might be.
Where are you just standing in the fridge?
Who?
Yeah, but Detroit is coming to E3, not being released this year.
Yeah, but I don't know. This is from what I was hearing. But, the game's been in fucking development for a little while, so.
What about the rumor that Sony's going to be announcing shit that's like fucking like 3 and 4 years off?
I don't
Like
that's what they do every year.
Yeah, but normally it's like it's not on purpose. It's not on purpose they announce a bunch of shit that's 3 and 4 years off. It just happens that way. I think the rumor is that they know this stuff is several years off.
No, so we know that because you could tell. Last year, I don't care what no one say. I said it last year, and I keep on saying it. Like,
well, look at it this way. When is the Final Fantasy remake, Final Fantasy VII remake coming?
2037. Star date, mind you. Star date. We will have spaceships in space, and there will be a Jean-Luc Picard. Before we get fucking Final Fantasy VII remake.
Well, you saw a comment.
That's my official E3 prediction.
Oh, so we can do that now. E3 predictions, right? Or we did that last week.
We kind of did that last week, but we have more like info. If you want to do it again.
No, that's kind of gay.
It is kind of gay, but so much shit happened. Oh.
Yeah.
What other Sony news? Is there more Sony news that leaked?
Okay, I know.
I had a.
What else? Did some okay? I could think. No, there's some shit.
But don't you guys find it funny though? Because remember, Microsoft been talking about their E3 press conference for almost a month now.
Microsoft's been talking about it. Well, yeah, they have. You're right. They've been dropping fucking pictures and shit because they hype. Think about what we about to see. We know what we about to see. We about to see Dead Rising, the good one, the one that everyone wants. No denying that Dead Rising 1 remade, and it looks like they're going to fucking, make it the whole city now? They're going to add to it?
Yep. You can come outside the mall and stuff.
So that's gonna be cool.
So is it a reboot or a fourth installment?
A remake. People thought it was a reboot. I mean, people thought
it's gonna,
it was
it's gonna
sequel,
have the clown in it.
A remake.
Hey, there he is.
Oh, what up, Stevie? All right.
Hey, what's going on?
It's gonna have the clown in it.
You don't remember that clown?
With the two goddamn chainsaws?
Yeah, he went crazy. Protecting the children, and he's protecting their bodies. He's supposed to be like an insane clown that's trying to protect these dead children that died from the zombie thing.
You know, I actually didn't play the first one all the way through.
Yeah, I didn't play it all the way through either.
Because I always thought it should have been a co-op game. Always.
That was so even my play. Reason. Where that's fact though, it should have been a co-op game. But yeah, I didn't like that timing. The timing system that fucked up that whole game. That fucked it up for me trying to play it again. Because you remember you had to deal with that whole timing thing. You couldn't be free and just do what you wanted to do.
Yeah, something like that. Seven. Yep.
Yeah, you had like an hour or something like that to play before you had to do something.
Yeah, you run out of time. But you can play it again. You can play it again with all your advancement, though. You know, they wanted you to come back and play it again and again and again to try to go to different parts of the mall and try different things. But they wouldn't let you do everything in one playthrough.
Yeah, that's bad design. Like, I hate that shit. But
that was also the first game that, like, the text on the screen was just for HDTVs. And it made a lot of people mad.
Yeah.
Fact.
Yeah.
I remember playing that shit on a projector. That was the first game I played on a projector. That shit was crazy. When they stole it from school, but that's a different story. There's a lot of shit I ain't doing that game now. Think about it. Cause I stopped playing, that story mode around the time all that weird religious shit was happening. All that cultist shit,
yeah, there's some fucking weird
shit. So you guys believe they're gonna up the zombie numbers in it?
They better.
Jesus.
They better. They gonna make it bigger?
You think the four-player co-op gonna add to it?
Yeah, well, if it's bigger, it can't be the same small size. They tell me it's like recreated one for one. I'm not gonna like that.
If what?
No, if they recreated one for one, I'm not gonna like it. That's not gonna be good. That's not enough space, in my opinion. Unless they up the zombie count fucking tremendously. Or you can't even fucking move.
Which I'm sure they will.
Yeah, but it's gonna have to be something crazy. I hope the AI is much better now also.
Some of that.
The AI was fucking horrible in that game, I'm sorry. Like,
Especially when you're trying to get people past the zombies and they're running right to them. And then they crouch down and the zombies start biting them. You're like, no.
But to be honest, like, that's kind of a reason why I kind of like that game, because the AI made the game kind of hard, even though you didn't want it to be that way.
Mm.
It was like, yo, these guys really might die, like, you might start fighting one zombie, and start fighting a whole fucking mob by themselves with a fucking...
This is still like a rumor leak, though, right?
Yeah.
Man, they took okay. Yeah, it's a rumor, all these are rumors, but...
Except for the Sony.
And they had a...
Yeah. All I heard about Sony is that the Dinosaur Robot game got delayed and Uncharted is the top of the APD or whatever the hell it is. The
NPD.
NPD, yeah. The Austin Police Department.
Detroit. Remember that game Detroit they was talking about? That game is looking to be announced. I think that's all we know, because they ain't been really saying shit at all for them. Besides, we know that VR shit gonna be there. I wonder how they... So, guys, how do you think they're gonna demo it? Let's talk about that. Or you guys can talk about it while I'm
talking. VR?
Yeah, because they have to demo it, right? Like, they can't just be talking about it.
Allegedly, they're gonna have, like, a whole shit ton of them for people to use.
That would give them the show hands down if they do the show in VR. But not I don't know how that's going to work for like the PlayStation experience where people can
do it in VR. What I'm saying is...
They're going to do that Nintendo shit.
Venomous said that... What did he say? You may want to avoid... He said, I could see E3 being for VR. Someone told me there are going to be lots of kiosks with PlayStation VR titles.
Mm. Well, you know, I went to the Microsoft store to test out the Vive. You can make an appointment and go mess with the Vive a little bit. And everybody there seemed to really think I was going to hurt myself. Like, I'm guessing people have been hurting themselves while testing out the VR stuff in the store, because they were like, watch out, you know, the cable's right there, and lift your foot. I mean, they were keeping an eye on me, like, real serious, like. So I don't,
what's your take on VR?
It's okay. I wasn't that impressed, but
I don't think I want to walk around. I don't think I want to fucking walk around, right, in a world.
Yeah. But I'm here's the thing. If you're going to have a massive E3... demo of VR kiosks, there might be a safety issue is what I'm trying to say.
I think there's going to be a health issue.
Yeah, well, yeah, there's also going to be some face grease getting from person to person to person, and eye boogers and whatever else, but
beyond that, do we know any, like, supposed games coming out for that, or anything?
But they had some games for the Vive that are actually out, but I don't know about, like, PlayStation VR.
Do you guys think Microsoft can just stick to the Oculus? Or you think
I don't think
have
there's
Vive
any reason why they can't
well.
Support, they won't be supporting all of the fucking PC. Everything that supports DirectX 12's APIs for VR, there's no reason... They shouldn't fucking use them all. Is there... Because from... do you want to transition into the Microsoft rumors? We already started, pretty much. We pretty much already started. So
yeah, I don't mind.
So we watched a video. I can't remember the guy's name. Sims. I can't remember. Brian, David, I don't remember. So anyways, Brad Sims was the one who originally leaked the Xbox information about there being new boxes. He didn't give out any more information but to say that they're going to be a new box. One was going to be a slim and the other one was going to be more powerful. It was Kotaku had the exact same stuff as he had. And during his live, he did it live. You can watch it on YouTube right now. He said that there was another unnamed project that Kotaku didn't announce, and he didn't want to say anything either. But he called what Kotaku did ballsy.
Yeah, because they mentioned names, code names. He said they weren't supposed to mention code names.
That's where the scorpion comes from.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that shit is real. When Brian says something, you can bank on that it was it. Just because it doesn't come out, just because he says something and then that shit doesn't come out, doesn't mean that shit wasn't real at one point. So if he says something's going on at Microsoft, you can pretty much bank on that something's going on. So interesting thing he said during the show was that the Microsoft Band, you know, their fitness watch, was originally an Xbox peripheral, which is pretty neat, but it just kind of branched out to its own thing. But he made some
is this back when the Xbox was going to look at your pulse and stuff like that.
No, it can do that probably. If you got a Kinect, it can do that
probably
now.
Yeah.
It doesn't need a fucking band to tell your pulse.
That's why I think Microsoft, if they implement the Kinect right with VR, they could have the best VR.
They can. They can have the cheapest true VR experience.
If they do it right.
They can have the cheapest true VR experience.
Or at because least augmented reality.
Because my thing is the Kinect can already like take up your room space. Your body.
It already sees your body. Yeah.
So a lot of the stuff the Kinect can do. But we'll see how they do it.
Yeah, it's something that can replace the Vive sensors. That's a lot of extra money Vive is spending on that, all those sensors that you have to set up. I could not set that up in my house right now.
Why not?
I got too much shit. I got shit that needs to fucking go into a storage shed. It's just sitting in my house. It's better than it was. We did some spring cleaning and I threw a whole bunch of my wife's stuff away. I threw a lot of my stuff away too, but most of the shit was her. Dude, for a while there we had like stacks of fucking of shit just in containers in the front room. Now we only have a half a stack of shit in containers in the front room. So it looks like we're not going to get any. So fucking Magnum was right. No announcements likely at E3 about either console, either of the new consoles, unless Microsoft.
But whoever. Cruel, we've been telling you that it don't make sense. Sony's big push is VR. That's coming in October.
And so that's automatic. Big push is UWP.
The other stuff is no.
Yeah.
But they're not gonna really push the UWP until the other thing comes.
Well, they need to push it now. As soon as possible, like, hey, at least to developers, maybe not to us, but at least to developers, be like, hey, you make
developers
these games,
know.
If you make these games but to this developers spec,
have a developers know, why do they need to come
no,
out?
No, not all developers know, right? Not every
well,
developer has a fucking kit. Not every developer is going to get a kit where they're going to be able to work.
Yeah, but we know,
the
they
hardware.
Know. If they're, if they're in a system, if they're really a developer, they know. We know, so they know. Like,
dude, the guys working on Subnautica don't know.
Well, guess what?
I guarantee you. But Microsoft, well,
then they shouldn't be in the industry.
Oh my god, dude. Not everybody gets fucking kits this fucking early. You know who has them? EA, Activision, Ubisoft. The guys that are fucking working on the preview program and the guys that are fucking self-publishing, they don't get fucking kits until later when there's extras. So what's going to happen is Microsoft will be like, hey, if you program your game to work at this certain spec, you'll be able to just publish it right onto the next Xbox. Right? So that's the benefit of UWP. They can publish the game on Windows now, and then when the next Xbox comes out, it'll automatically just work on there.
I'm not buying what you're saying. They don't have to fucking do that at E3 for those guys to follow. They can do some backroom shit. They don't need to go out in E3, fuck up their sales now, just to let developers know.
I didn't say to go to fucking E3. And who gives a fuck? This goddamn generation is over, dude. It is over.
You do.
Stick a motherfucking fork in it, dude. This goddamn part of the generation is over. The Xbox One is done. Dude, the Xbox One is fucking done.
We're not changing our arguments. We're not changing our arguments.
It's not a change of argument. It's part of the argument.
There's no reason for them. There's no reason for
them. It's the only reason I need, Sean. It's the only reason. The fucking system is dead, dude. As far as they're concerned, the Xbox One is done.
You know what?
If you're not number one, you're the first loser.
If they believe it was done, they would announce the Scorpio at E3. They don't believe that. It's not done yet. It's gonna be done next year. That's why they're not gonna announce it. It would be stupid for them to announce it now. Because it's not done.
But I'm gonna tell you this original Xbox One is done. This original model is done. When the Slim come out, that's it. The Slim is gonna be the new Xbox One, and the Scorpion gonna be the new.
No, the fuck, the barn. This shit gonna be that.
So you're not gonna buy
Fuck you. Fuck you for asking me that. How about that? I'm gonna buy a Slim and then I'm gonna buy a Scorpio. Nice. No. What would I do that for? Just waste the money?
That's what I was wondering.
I'm not really in the mood to buy something and wait for some games to show up at this point. They're going to have to sell that Scorpion with some new
shit. That's the good thing with it being backward compatible.
I ain't buying a new console for backward compatibility right now. You know what I mean? If they want to sell me a new console, they need to put some big games out there. And they need to say, hey, you know, this is...
So Xbox One is great. Halo 6? Halo 6... I think like the Gears of War 4 and all, I'm gonna be upgradable.
Every single game that you see on the fucking Windows Store now will be playable on the new console at higher resolution.
But I don't want just I agree with thing. I don't just want higher resolution and frame rate. I want to see a significant difference.
Yep.
You're getting 4 times the power. You better give me at least 2 times the graphics.
You're not just getting.
That's probably why we're not gonna see Halo 6 until next E3.
You're not gonna just get a fucking game with the same fucking textures. It's not gonna happen. You're gonna get the shit that's on PC spec'd for the new system. That's what you'll see. And fucking the fucking shit that works on an Xbox One will work automatically. The shit that works on PCs, 6 teraflop PCs, will work on the Xbox One. You see what I'm saying? The shit on the Xbox One looks like shit next to the PC version. That has nothing to do with resolution and everything to do with texture resolution. And that's the big thing, that the ability to process that fucking huge amounts of textures on a fucking better GPU. That's going to be the big deal. So a lot of the stuff that you see on PCs will just, it just simply looks better because it has higher resolution textures. And that's the difference. That's why Skyrim, textures in Skyrim that users have made look better than most games' textures that you see today. Character models. There are character models created by users for Skyrim that look better than Uncharted 4. They don't move better than Uncharted 4. But they look better.
Yeah, if you were to put them into the Source filmmaker, you could make them move better. Yeah. Eventually.
And according to rumors, and
Blizzard would make it to you now.
According to rumors, there's a Skyrim release coming up soon.
Yeah.
Who really cares about that?
There is
a whole nother world that you never experienced in Skyrim if they support mods.
I care.
There are huge fucking mods that are awesome. There's a mod out there that takes the war that doesn't happen in the game at all and creates it. There are huge battles. You could just be walking down a road and there'll be a fucking massive battle in the middle of a
Randy
fucking
Savage field. Dragons.
Randy Savage Dragons. God, there are some fucking awesome ass mods out there. If they support mods,
they do the same thing for the Fallout games too, by the way. If you ever go look at all the mods for New Vegas and Fallout 4, and there's a lot of people making crazy mods for that shit.
Yeah, but nothing fucking touches Skyrim. Nothing touches. There are complete and total conversions of that game if they support that. But
isn't New Vegas the one where they find a crashed Star Destroyer and you can go aboard and shit and find dead stormtroopers? And I mean, they do some pretty crazy shit.
There are some pretty fun stuff on the game. Yeah.
All I know is they better have Kinect support.
They're not going to have Kinect support.
With all the fucking
I hope the new console, even if they don't make a new Kinect, they put the Kinect port on that shit, the Scorpio. Otherwise, I'll be one Scorpio less having Xbox.
If the rumors are true, they should have enough power to add some fucking Kinect shit if they wanted to.
I just want my Kinect port.
Yeah, I don't know. All I know is if it doesn't have Kinect, I'm not going through all those menus. Sorry.
I'm not buying it. I'm dead ass. No Kinect, no me.
And that's how I enjoyed it. Like, unless it looks super.
Isn't that what Tony Stark said? That's how Dad made him?
But yeah,
dude, I don't care. I'll fucking play it if it has mods. If it doesn't have mods, I'm not gonna touch it. I don't give a fuck. I got it on my PC. So I'd like to be able to just sit back on my couch though and fucking play it with fucking mods. That'd be great.
Does Sony have anything coming out this year anymore?
Dude.
The Last Guardian, I think.
Sports? The fucking DT Sports?
They got the Call of Duty stuff.
Okay.
I don't know. They've got to announce something that's coming out this year, right?
Yeah, they seem to have been hollowed out as far as why you should get Sony for the rest of the year.
Well, that was the same thing last year. And then they had a whole bunch of shit get pushed to the beginning of this year.
I'm almost afraid they're going to bring out, like, Bungie to show the new Destiny add-on or something.
Of course they will.
And you're like, well, it's just got special shit for the PlayStation 4 as the game dies. in the last few seconds.
So, let's do what we could already know is going to happen. So, the multi-platform, Call of Duty, like you said. Well,
Destiny.
What other third person or third party?
There'd be Activision,
Is there any other major game coming out? Like,
you think they're gonna have anything for Red Dead?
Nah, I don't think so.
I don't know, but if they announce Red Dead 2 or 3, it would be 3. Yeah. If they announce 3, they better fucking
3?
Yes, 3.
Where's the second Red Dead?
The first Red Dead was before
it
was like a GTA game.
We're talking about Redemption. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
A sequel to Redemption, fuck that.
Well, they were talking that it might be a prequel. There's a whole bunch of shit they got. A whole bunch of background story into that game. So a prequel would make sense as well.
Man, shoot, fuck that. The DLC was a prequel, wasn't it? Fuck.
What, the zombie one?
Wasn't... Oh, no, that was in the game just playing as the thing.
So I wonder if they're going to announce their fucking... their zombie game. If Microsoft's going to announce their zombie game from Dead Labs.
Oh, that was another rumor. Yeah, that was. That was a rumor. Dead Labs is supposed to announce State of Decay 2. I don't want State of Decay 2, to be honest. I more want, what was it, Class
the
4
MMO?
Or whatever it was, that other game. Yeah, that's what I want.
The State of Decay MMO?
Yeah.
Because they've been pretty fucking quiet. A fucking good zombie MMO? I don't know, dude. That would be pretty fucking awesome.
That would.
If they don't have it, they need to have co-op. Like.
No. They indicated, they said it's going to have co-op. That's one of the...
Because the Xbox 360 version of State of Decay has co-op, right?
No, none of them have co-op.
Yeah, I think the 360 version has co-op.
Oh, no. Wait, is that...
I think they added it onto the 360 version, but not the PC or Xbox One versions. I thought they did.
No, I don't think it got co-op. I don't think it got co-op.
I'm going to go log into my fucking Xbox 360 and check it out. That shit should be backwards compatible if it has co-op. The remake is... it's using Unreal Engine 4, isn't it?
I don't know.
I hope that this fucking whatever this Red Dead, this Undead Lab shit is fucking awesome. They are a good developer, so
it will be. They have Microsoft is giving them a lot of time because I remember they was giving out when they were doing.
Well, it is like a 3-game deal or something.
Yeah, I think so. Something I think like it was a 3-game deal.
Yeah, like they were doing what Dev Diaries, and they were talking about State of Decay, the new one they had dropped, and how they're buying time and shit like that.
Literally, we're buying their time. More people that bought State of Decay bought them more time.
Yeah, we're. But yeah, I can't wait for that.
I wonder what big games, third party. What big third party games? You think fucking Battlefield?
Battlefield is going to be sold like hell. Yeah, they're going to show that blimp blowing up and everything else.
You think they're going to show it at Microsoft's press conference?
Yeah,
they might. Yeah, they've been defending the free stuff for Microsoft. You know, the early.
Oh my god!
So they're gonna show it.
Yeah, they got the marketing deal.
They're going to show the guys in the boats with the battleships firing in the water and stuff like that. That's what they're going to show. And the blimp blowing up.
Yeah, unfortunately, I just...
What are you talking about?
Battlefield 1.
Microsoft showing Battlefield.
And how they've tied themselves to Microsoft a little bit for it. So they'll be up on the stage.
I think they'll show gameplay. They'll play it like they did with the last game.
Yeah, that wouldn't be bad. I don't know. I just wish, especially since they had their own conferences now, that everyone just do their own fucking thing. Like talk about Fiji. I don't know. Me personally, I wouldn't want to see it there. But, you know, it's not a show for us. Show for the public.
I'm pretty sure Cuphead's gonna be there.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh, they're gonna show.
Definitely.
I guess they're gonna show a different part of the game
with a release date.
Yeah, I think they're going to show a different part of their game, though. I think they added platforming into it and stuff.
They actually showed that.
Hopefully they show Below.
Oh my god, Below needs to fucking come out.
Yeah.
That should come out like fucking for free. We've waited so long for that fucking game.
We haven't waited that long.
It was announced the fucking 2013. Dude, 3 years for a fucking indie game? That's out of control.
But shit. Y'all know what they had to fucking add and shit. What is it?
Gigantic still needs to have an official release. And Sea of Thieves.
Yeah, that game. Give that game some time, man. Because I'm liking what I see out of that with the gameplay for the platform. And so, give them some time. Let them cook.
There's probably going to be a God of War announcement on the Sony side.
God of War 4, yeah. It'll be out in, like, next year, though, right?
I kind of hope that Kratos attacks the Norse god and gets the living shit kicked out of him, and they leave everybody in shock. Kratos is, like, looking at his chopped-off arm and shit, going, oh, my god, what did you... And then he looks up, and they step on his head or something, and it goes dark.
Oh, no, sorry.
I'm sorry, like, can we stop talking about people running franchises to the ground when it comes to Microsoft when you could fucking... Take a franchise, remove the main character, bring it to a whole new setting, and everyone fucking goes up and loves that shit. Like, are you kidding me?
What Gran Turismo are we going up to now? Seven?
Sport or something like that?
But I could understand that. You can't tell me that you're going to take your main or one of your biggest flagship titles, remove the main character from that, go to another setting, and everyone's just okay with it. Nothing. What do you mean? It's just, you know.
Sony's doing it, so it's fine.
Wow. Call of Duty Infinite Warfare using a dated engine.
Everybody's really going off on Call of Duty this year. They want it dead.
They're still going to buy it in droves.
They were mad when Ghost came
They're
out.
They're still gonna bite me.
Honestly,
they gave Black Ops 3 a break, but I swear they want Call of Duty dead now.
No, but to be honest, this could be the sea changer. I'm not the one that always fucking just go with what's popular. And the reason why is because this really is space. Motherfuckers hate space. The reason why a lot of people hate Halo, they just really hate that space shit. Like, I thought people, outside.
Yeah, they're gonna fight on Titan and shit.
Yeah,
they're gonna fight on the moon of Saturn.
They literally
what Call of Duty? You mean?
Yeah, it's not just like near future. It's not just near future. Like okay. I've got like a robot suit that makes me stronger. It's like no, we're fighting in the moons of Saturn.
Yeah, it's Halo. We're out in space.
It's pretty much it's exactly. It's become Halo. It's become UNSC.
Yeah, we're so it's like. Now it's like, you know, and it's crazy because they're trying so hard not to call it space, like a space shooter, but it fucking clearly is, so it's like, damn.
Yeah, but the space shooting is like,
with real guns. I thought
it's space shooting. No, it's like on rails, right?
I don't know.
Ghost Recon game looks fucking amazing.
Yeah.
That fucking Wildlands? Jesus Christ.
Hey. We'll see what happens when it comes down to the sales.
Isn't it basically about you invading Venezuela? that whole Wildlands game?
That game, it's a reimagining of the first one in third person. I can't wait. Not the first one, not the PC one. I'm talking about the one I played on Xbox. I ain't played the PC one. Before it came out, like, that one just being dropped into an open world and just going after whoever's there for whatever mission you're on. Like, I love that. That was so great. Like, that shit. Everything's watered down. Oh, shit. If they drop OG backwards compatibility, I could play the first Ghost Recon.
Huh? Yeah, if they drop it, and that's another rumor. OG backwards compatible games. sort of like what PlayStation's doing with PS2.
Mm.
Oh, here's something that's interesting.
Hey, Mafia 3, only one second, Ninja Gaiden.
Lincoln may get police response for simply being in a certain white-only zone. Like, maybe he goes into a white bathroom or something. Dude, I'm going to have to play that fucking game.
Wait, Mafia? Yeah, Mafia look crazy.
What?
You're going to be jacking people in white people.
I'm going to be jacking white people in fucking white bathrooms. White-only bathrooms. I hope you can drink from white-only fountains, too.
Yeah, but you bored.
I'd be an asshole. Like, I'm going to drink from this white-only fountain.
You're not being an asshole. That's not being an asshole if you're drinking from a white-only fountain.
That's good, man.
Being belligerent about it is being an asshole, though. Drinking it because you're thirsty is not being an asshole about it. You're thirsty. You need some fucking water. Drinking something to drink from it because you want to be belligerent and it's being an asshole.
But yeah.
What other shit? What about the Xbox update? Has anyone else gotten the new Xbox One update?
I don't think so.
So it's just me.
This is the one that's supposed to be the all the new features that's actual kind of the new direction they're going in.
They need Cortana needs a ton of fucking work. Yeah, Cortana needs a lot of work. I've already reported several issues, so that's what these things are here for. We're going to see Mass Effect as well. Forgot about that. We'll probably see gameplay of Mass Effect. They'll probably announce...
There's a new game out. There's a new game out from the guys who did Saints Row, Volition. They got something called Team Mayhem or something like that, where you got like three characters in a city that looks a lot like the one in Crackdown, and they're supervillains.
What they were saying is like a mix of Overwatch and Saints Row.
Kinda, yeah. It's a robot future.
I want to play that game.
It looked pretty good.
Climb up, Laura. Come on. You can't even climb the wall of a castle.
What big disappointments do you think are going to happen at E3? What do you think gets delayed? I think Last Guardian gets delayed into next year.
No, I think that's going to finally come. They can't delay that shit.
They really need the shitter get off the pot.
Exactly. They can't delay it again. If they delay that game again, might as well just scrap it.
Just start crowdfunding it. Hey.
Exactly. Hey,
put money to finish this game.
Oh, you mean
on
like
Kickstarter. That,
but you guys saw that. You saw the IGN. I didn't watch it.
Huh? Me?
It didn't look interesting to me. But you guys seen the IGN documentary they have it on the game, or developer diaries they have it on the game. So it's definitely coming out. Looks the same exact way, unfortunately, but it's coming out. At least in the clip I saw.
Oh shit! They wanna do a HD remaster of Enslaved, apparently.
That's not bad. I like that game.
I kind of liked it. I don't know how much of it I remember anymore, other than you know it being real green in the first part.
I don't want a remaster. Like you see, that's another thing. Is it a remaster or?
What about that game though? You think you can hear anything about that game? That sequel to Heavenly Sword?
No, I haven't heard anything about that either. Yeah. They were talking about that back when they finished Devil May Cry, though, but that was the last I heard of it. Doing the more Heavenly Sword stuff. They had like a commercial talking about the next the next Heavenly Sword teaser stinger thing. Mm. Like they showed a woman with a sword, like another woman. Mm. And people were trying to figure out whether it was her sister with the crossbow or not.
You gotta be fighting the fucking... I don't know what the fuck this is. Oh,
Halo shit, franchise sales are totaled over 7 million now.
70.
Yeah, the franchise. Wow. 70 million.
7 times 10.
Yeah, 7 times 10, that's what I meant to say.
Yeah.
The Wolf Among Us 2 is another rumor.
Oh, there's talk of a Telltale doing a Star Wars thing too.
God damn it, I don't give a fuck about that. I need the Wolf Among Us. Dude, I wanna
I'm not a big Fables fan.
I wanna play as Bigby.
Yeah, I'm not a big Fables fan, but
dude, Bigby is so fun to play.
If you have a PS4, Powers 2 is out.
Oh my god, dude. At the end of the game, when you get the choice to rip the dude's head off.
Hey, motherfucker.
You're not going to play.
Yeah, don't spoil it for me, Puel.
Yes, I am.
Hey, I started playing it, Puel.
Oh, did you start playing it?
I got that shit.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to spoil it.
Hey, I didn't spoil it. I just said, you know, something.
Yo, all I know is you fuck with me, you ain't playing no Uncharted game. Think I'm playing. Think I'm playing Uncharted 2 and 3. Come on.
Man.
But nah.
Dude, that is fucking... The game is good. You're gonna be a total fucking dickhead and just go wolf on people. That's hilarious. Hmm. Or you could be nice. I try to be nice to people. And then when you do something crazy, like go wolf, they're even more surprised. They're like, he was so nice, and then he did something crazy. It's pretty good. It's creepy, dude. It gets into some creepy shit, too. Like, there's prostitution and shit.
That's what Fables is all about, is creepy shit. You have to read it.
It's creepy as fuck. No PC version of Injustice 2.
Why?
They stopped supporting the first game.
Warner Brothers messed up their Batman game, so now they're backing off, I guess. The PC.
You guys think they're gonna show Shadow of Mordor too?
That would be.
I never played the first one.
I would like to see them go back and do something with like in the past. There's a lot. There's the lore of fucking is huge.
The Silmarillion stuff.
Yeah, maybe you could play the guy who fucks his sister on accident and kills the dragon, and then realizes that he's been banging his sister and got her pregnant. He finally learns the truth because the dragon tells him. Yeah, that's a great story. I want to play
that one. Shit I don't ever want to know in my head.
That's like, basically Star Wars.
That's basically Star Wars.
Hey, thank God I don't like Star Wars. We all know that.
The Force Awakens.
Yeah, everything runs its course.
Someone's gonna redo the hard reset. Oh, they already did.
Yeah, it's out already.
I don't know why
people are complaining about it because it doesn't have like really hard shadows. It has like kind of soft ambient shadows, and so everyone thinks it looks like there's less shadows. It's one of those cases where the crazy light and dark look is better than the real look.
Yeah.
Realism actually made it look worse.
What do we think about Nintendo? Do we have anything for Nintendo?
They're basically going to have Zelda and some smaller shit, and that's it, from what I understand. And those are...
Yeah.
That's Nintendo's words.
Like Nintendo's Zelda, not even really there. They're just going to have, like, a treehouse type thing, except it's going to be... But
they're going to have a Zelda thing, basically.
Hmm.
Yeah. They're doing their own little thing.
Hey, listen. At the end of the day, right, Nintendo is a legacy console. It's always going to be your secondary console. I don't know why people hate on Nintendo. I think gamers are very disrespectful, because if it wasn't for Nintendo, there wouldn't be any video. It wouldn't have any gaming. And that's God's honest truth. You know what? So at the end of the day, they may have lost their way, or they're doing some shit now that people can't comprehend. But you know what? That's Nintendo.
Dude.
And I think
for your dad, you wouldn't be
shut up.
You can interrupt me.
No, I didn't interrupt. I didn't finish.
So
people like Kuel and them who think that gaming started with Sony need to stop. They really need to stop.
But gaming people who think that gaming started with Nintendo also need to stop, because it started way back with fucking Atari.
And really Atari as well almost killed gaming.
Pong was the first big blow, so.
Yeah, but Atari almost killed gaming.
Well, yeah, but it kept going in lots of places. It was in garages and
Julio
shit.
Julio said Damien is a crazy guy who lives on an island.
Yeah, so Nintendo saved gaming. Like, nah, he sacked Atari and shit, but yeah, that garage.
I don't know. Why would Nintendo
saying, really Game, Game I didn't start in 1985. That's all I'm trying to say. There was a good 15, well, a good 10 years of it before that. All the really
yeah, but
77 is when it got into bars and, you know, stopped being pinball and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
When the real video game thing started.
Nintendo is the attitude era of, you know, the attitude era in wrestling. That's the attitude era of video games.
We can also thank Nintendo for laws that prevent companies from forcing their partners from releasing shit on other devices. because they were fucking telling their people who were making games for the NES that if they made games for the Sega Master System, that they wouldn't allow the game to be published on the NES.
Hey, competition.
I wouldn't blame them because I think any human would eventually do that. Just because Nintendo did it doesn't mean like fucking.
Well, I mean, there were laws created because of that, so.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you're right.
So there's laws in America that keep companies from doing that. And that was because Nintendo. They were dickheads about that. Apparently Sega was bigger than Nintendo in Europe. Europe is such a weird fucking
place. Mega Drive probably was a big deal.
Mega Drive was big.
Hold on, I'm gonna be back. But yeah, I continue.
What other fucking rumors? Off the top of my head I can't think of anything. No, they won't announce a new Tomb Raider, will they?
Mm.
I don't want
to. No,
a
I
Tomb
don't think
Raider
so.
Right
too
now.
Soon. No.
If Eidos wants to do something cool besides Deus Ex, they need to bring back the Soul Reaver stuff.
Oh my god, that would be awesome.
It doesn't have to be Soul Reaver. It could just be Blood Omen, but whatever. Something from Nazgoth.
Redo the first game.
Or just
what's,
just do
what's what you would redo. They don't need to redo the Jack. Do something new.
Well, they
most people haven't even played the first game though.
Those games are Legend of Zelda clones, okay? They're just dark Legend of Zelda clones. Kind of like Darksiders was. But just something in that universe would be good. And not like kart racing,
the
like vampire kart racing.
I would not mind a Legacy of Kain.
Yeah, I would just try to do something in there with that.
They own some pretty good fucking franchises to work with. Microsoft has a fucking shit ton of franchises to work with, and they need to fucking start working on some of those franchises.
Oh, they're licensing them out now. The Fastest stuff they're licensing out to the guys who.
So you guys really think we're going to see a Battlefield?
I'm fine with them licensing out Fastest stuff. I think we're seeing Battlefield 1 on stage.
Battletoads.
Oh, Battletoads. I don't know,
dude. Iron Galaxy doing Battletoads.
Oh my god.
Dave Lang in Chicago.
I don't know what the fuck to think about that.
If they can get that horrible Michael Bay Ninja Turtle look, it would be perfect. If they could make fun of the new Ninja Turtles with Battletoads, that would be almost perfect. Just do like their own horrible Ninja Turtles.
Actually, yeah, that would be perfect. I agree. I just came back to hear that. That was the whole point of Battletoads, right?
Yeah.
Hey, you think they would give it to Platinum Games?
Maybe. I mean, they
would
Transformers.
You know what? I'd buy it.
They did Transform, but didn't they also do the same Ninja Turtles?
Yeah, they did the new Ninja Turtles game, but nobody
likes
it.
And that's a crock of crap.
Well, I don't know if it's all that bad. It's just not many people are that crazy about it. It's
Road
not
Rush.
Like
I mean, Road Rush.
It's based off of the comics, right? Not the fucking movie.
Kind of. Yeah, it's the darker, the stuff that was like a Frank Miller parody in the '80s.
Fucking Frank Miller! What a fucking dick, dude.
Everybody's a ninja.
Yeah.
Didn't Donatello just die though?
I don't know.
I think Donatello died recently.
That's the modern comics. That's not even the same studio doing all that. That's licensed guys.
Hey, you know what they should do? They should bring back Contra. Oh, they did already. It's called Gears of War.
They don't really play it all the same.
That is not no fucking controversy.
Yeah, it's the
spot. But it kind of, you kind of, I can see what you're talking about.
If you made a Gears of War game like Contra, I think it would sell. I would probably buy it. You know, we have like the little guys just.
You don't think Gears of War is the modern day Contra?
Nah, it's way slower. It just don't work. I don't remember anyone in Contra going Maria.
Yeah, hey, that's why I say modern day.
They always save their chicks, right?
There weren't any chicks. Contra had one story. Falcon, Blue Falcon was saving the Earth from the alien invasion.
The later Contra games had chicks as characters where you could just like.
Oh right, like hard corpse and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, it got weirder and weirder. Contra, everything after Contra 3 was just weird.
Hey, Contra 3 was a classic.
They could bring back Bionic Commando, I guess.
Oh my god.
No, they tried it. They tried that.
My arm isn't my wife anymore. It's my cousin.
Let me see how far back in you guys' gaming history you could go. Any of you guys remember Street Fighter 2018?
Wasn't that the horrible?
That was a Nintendo. That was a Nintendo thing.
Yeah, but no, it was Capcom made it.
Yeah, but it was for the Nintendo. It wasn't like a. You know what I mean? It wasn't like part of the Street Fighter arcade thing. It was just like
a weird little
adventure where Ken was in the future fighting mutants from the moon or some shit, and he was a scientist.
Yeah, I don't remember that. I definitely don't remember that.
It has nothing to do with Street Fighter whatsoever. They just said Ken's in it and it's the future, and here's a bunch of monsters. It's hilariously not Street Fighter.
This can't end well.
What can't?
A video with a guy play with a freaking crocodile, alligator, like tapping it on his nose and putting his hand in his mouth. So that's why I said this can't end well. I knew it. Oh, it took his fingers.
But DC.
What about Banjo? A Banjo game.
I was never really a fan of Banjo game, you know.
Not either.
But it would. Yeah, EA's back in that ripoff of a ukulele or whatever with a lizard and a bat.
Like, I expect a cop.
I can't hear you, dude.
You're fucking quiet again.
I say Conker. You hear me now?
Yeah.
What happened to Conker? He's been teasing Conker for mad long.
He went on crack.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck is Conker wouldn't surprise me.
No, I want it. The fuck surprises. I want it. Like, they've been teasing you for 2 years. Project Spark started. Oh, they did that shit. But Project Spark died. They don't even know about the fucking back.
Anyway, enough game talk. Who you guys think gonna win tonight?
Hold on. Before we do that, what do you guys think is gonna happen at the PC conference? Like, you guys think it's gonna be horrible at Classic?
The who?
Oh! Turok!
The PC console.
Turok's getting a reboot.
No, it's not.
Really? Yes, it
Turok
is.
Turok is just getting released.
Dude, I'm
It looks like crap. Rebooted. Did you see what it looks like? It looks like garbage, man.
The first game was garbage looking.
Which Turok are you guys talking about? The one that came out? On a
the Dinosaur Hunter.
I know.
I heard that they're gonna redo it. I heard they're gonna they're bring it back.
The N64 one.
Jesus, dude! Microsoft owns so much shit. How about bringing back some fucking What about bringing back some Age Ofs? Yeah, Age of Empires, Age of Mythologies. They own both of them.
They have an Age of Empire Online thing that just shut down here recently.
Yeah, they shut it down. I was playing
that
it for a while.
That shit was horrible.
Flight Simulator?
Hey, that shit's popular, man.
Lost Odyssey? I would not mind that. What else? Mech Assault? Mech Warrior? Yeah, Mech Commander? They own all three of those.
You need one of those types of games, though.
They own Monster Truck Madness, dude! They own Monster Truck Madness. 99 Nights? Dude,
I just posted a link to that Street Fighter 2010 game that Damien was talking about.
I could see them doing another 99 Nights would be a nice game to have.
Little game. Like
RC Pro-Am, that'd be a nice little game to have. Rise of Legends and Rise of Nations. Sudeki? Dude, I would fucking love a Sudeki re-release. I love that game.
But yeah, like I was saying, what's going on with the PC conference? What do you guys think?
I don't know anything about it. It was fucking cringe.
I'm saying, what do you think they're going to talk about?
It's just Radeon again, isn't it? AMD?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's probably AMD.
You think they're going to talk about architecture? Something like, what are they going to fucking show? Alright, fuck it. Of course.
Persona 5's coming out in February next year.
Yeah. Niche games. I never really liked the Persona games, so they're kind of creepy.
Are you talking about Persona? Yeah, I ain't played those games. Eh. I don't know about creepy. Only game that picked out was Persona. It's just kind of creepy.
Dude, Azurik. They should make it an Azurik sequel.
The Fall of Parathia.
The Fall of Parathia. And make it all dark and shit, where people are dying and you're trying to save them. And the main character from the fucking first game is like getting skewered, and you're like picking up his weapon. You can hardly use it. And you're running and trying to get away. Everybody's super stronger than you.
And the textures still look like utter shit.
Yeah. You start playing, and as you play the game, it gets stronger, the textures get better. Wow. And you're grinding to make the game look better.
Yo. Talk about indie games. What's up with that super hot? Does that come out? Like, what's up with that game?
All I heard was hot, hot, hot.
Yeah, that's it. That's all I heard.
Word?
What is it? Because I just heard the hot, hot, hot part.
Oh, no, super hot. What's up with that game?
I have no clue what that game is.
Is that that weird shooter that stops when you run and stuff?
Oh, yeah.
That shit. What's up with that game? Like, I want to play that shit. I want to try it out. I hear it's not too long or nothing, but I still want to try it out. How many of those Pikmin games back in the day? Playing Pikmin in school. Stick guys ran that shit.
Looks like GOG's got it for $20, but nobody's got it really on sale. Yeah. I don't know, because it looks big, you know, you're shooting weird, you know, red guys.
You came up all fucked up. You went robot on us right there.
You're mainly shooting mannequin guys, like red mannequin guys in the game. It has weird graphics that are kind of primitive.
What happened to Red Faction?
They just stopped that last that didn't that well and GQ went away. The other thing that Volition was making was the Red Faction games. And they made the one where you fight the aliens on Mars, and they didn't make any money, so they kind of just dropped it.
I love that one, Red Faction Guerrilla.
I like 3. I don't know about the 4th one though. It was kind of just a third person shooter.
I don't know.
It still had a lot of that destructibility stuff.
Yeah. I think it was the best last gen in terms of destructibility. Games I can remember. But, I don't know. I would like another Red Faction. Another Red Faction would be good.
Well, that Team Mayhem or Project Mayhem might have some of that in it because they were kind of subtly suggesting that Saints Row and Red Faction happened in the same universe, even though they couldn't because the Earth blew up at Saints Row. they're kind of implying that the evil corporation on Mars was the same one that was messing with you in Saints Row.
Okay, but Red Faction Guerrilla, Red Faction. What's the storyline behind that? I don't remember it.
Red Faction is Mars, and there's a breakaway group in Mars, and then there's Earth government.
Yeah.
But so Earth is still there, so it can't be the same thing.
Well, the Earth government took over from the corporation, and then they started abusing the shit out of people too. And then that's what 3 was about, was you running the Earth off. And then in 4, you somehow, some idiot wakes up aliens on Mars and they start killing everything. But, what was the name of that corporation? Omnicore or something like that? It was the big Saints Row villain for a while. But it was like the same company.
Well, too bad they blew up the world, so it's not fucking that cool. What else is coming out? I want to play that Way of the Warrior 2. Or whatever that game is. No, I said Way of the Warrior. Shadow Warrior. When does that come out?
Oh, the second one? I'm not sure.
Yeah, that one looks fantastic. That looks beyond fantastic.
There's also that weird thing Ubisoft is working on where you have like Vikings and Knights fighting each other in a big multiplayer. It's going to be like multiplayer chivalry with lots of people on the screen. It's going to be chivalry, but lots of people on the screen.
Isn't there a game, an RPG, a third person, or a first person RPG coming out? Kingdom Come, some shit like that?
Yeah, that's medieval Poland.
Next year.
That's next year? Okay.
Yeah, that's going to be next year. They just got into the beta.
Oh, yeah. So, you know, that means they're coming over to Scorpio.
There's a new South Park game coming out, too, so they might push that at E3.
Didn't that get released for backwards compatibility, the old South Park?
I'm not sure.
I think.
But the new one they're doing like superheroes is supposed to be the theme. They're gonna stop all the fantasy stuff and do superheroes.
Well, like costumes or shit.
And of course Cartman's is as racist as possible. while still having a little bit of an innocent explanation that you don't quite buy. Like he was the Grand Wizard in the last one, and this one I think he's called Coon or something terrible like that. Just total goddamn bullshit.
The Grand Wizard.
Yeah. He was the Grand Wizard in the last game. And this one he's going to be called the Coon. Like a raccoon guy.
Oh, yeah. He's a flying raccoon like Mario.
Yeah. But they're always doing that whole Cartman is racist and maybe doesn't even know it. Like he's just naturally, instinctively doing the most racist shit he possibly can kind of by accident.
The fucking,
I don't know.
Nothing will beat the fucking ginger shit.
Well, don't.
Yeah.
Okay. You know what? I'll... hallway.
Yeah, the whole ginger thing is hilarious.
Oh, For Honor is the name of that game I was talking about with the Vikings and the Samurai and the Knights.
Oh, okay.
All fighting. And I take it you get together like 30 or 40 people and, you know, you all fight together.
Oh, hell yeah, that was fucking great.
Ubisoft has a big link to their conference on June 13th at 1 p.m. So, that's like Monday, I think. They're not going to have Toby Turner back this time, I know that.
Ironside?
Was it Ironside?
Michael Ironside?
That was fucking worse.
Whatever.
God. Michael Ironside needs to reprise his role as fucking...
Yeah.
Sam Fisher.
Kill the new Sam Fisher. At the very end of the game, Michael Ironside comes out and breaks his neck. We're going back to fourth echelon. Fifth echelon is crap. Yeah.
But, you know what?
That's a fucking franchise I wouldn't mind seeing get rebooted.
Yeah.
I was just going to say that. Yeah, I was just going to say, I could see it being rebooted and being really, really great.
I'd like to reboot it and reboot it where he's a little bit younger and has a family.
They should start it off with Sam Fisher as Samantha Fisher and a woman, and then they kill her, and then they replace it with your Sam Fisher. just to make everyone angry.
You guys are already fucking up the franchise already.
Doing things just to piss people off.
Yeah.
Hey, you already fucking up the franchise. Alright, when you put in the family, all that cliche shit has to happen. It just has to. They take over his family, you gotta go save your daughter, save your spouse, fighting for the pop. That bullshit.
Then 2 games later, it turns out your daughter works for the other side. Yeah. She's not dead.
Sure. That shit's stupid. Like, I want him just being sent out on missions, alright? Yo, you gotta go do this. And some back.
They should be missions about like global warming and shit. Make them missions about global warming and microaggressions. All kinds of crap like that.
Fucking microaggressions.
You're on a fucking mission to stop a whale killing in Japan, jump from boat to boat. Nah, but that shit crazy. Like that vibe you got from the first couple of Splinter Cells, it's your mission to go out there. There's some backstory, but it's not really clear what's going on. That's the vibe I see.
Just don't make it episodic, because that's what they're doing with Hitman right now, and it's kind of pissing me off. I want to buy a game. I don't want to buy a subscription.
That's fine. I lost someone bought that. I told him day one, he didn't believe me. I'm like, yo, they're dropping some piece now. He's like, you know what? Whatever. I like the game. So, I think they just released the third one. I heard those sort of third thoughts. That's horrible, to be honest. I don't like that at all. That's the only reason why I ain't fishing. Fucking episodic. AAA game. Don't get A separate. 1A, 2A. But I think that's it. Because there's nothing really
Are we done then? Did Damien already leave?
You already know how to act. Fire for the past 20 minutes. So, DVG, who wins? Warriors or Cleveland? No.
I don't know. I'm not following basketball or anything right now. People were asking about the Penguins and the freaking Sharks like last 2 weeks ago. And I was like, I don't know.
The Warriors or...
I think Sharks are bigger than Penguins. What the hell is that?
That's his fucking phone. Okay. He's actually, he's using his phone.
I was like, are you kazooing me off and shit? Just blow the kazoo until he goes away. He doesn't like football. He doesn't like basketball. He's got to go.
You should have been an asshole and been like, yeah, I think that Cleveland wins by 2 touchdowns.
Yeah.
They could win by 14 points.
Yeah. Try to name a baseball team and say that I think they'll win by a touchdown.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think the Rangers will take it with 2 touchdowns.
2 touchdowns.
The Rangers, that's a baseball team.
I saw a team win by more than 2 touchdowns.
The Cubs
beat a team 16-0 and the fucking pitcher threw a no-hitter. Arrieta threw a no-hitter and the Cubs scored 16 runs. It was the most lopsided no-hitter since like 1884.
I think I saw a baseball game once where they won by 8 points and everybody was like half of the stadium was shaking their heads.
It was over. Yeah, you don't
8 runs. 8. That's just no. This isn't. I'm getting out of here. No.
at 8 runs, people start going home.
That's where people like. That's why they have plastic bottles instead of glass bottles now. throw that shit out of the field.
Well, you. If it's a home team, right? There are people that'll go home even if it's the home team.
Yeah. 8 runs is just you don't want to be there. You don't. We didn't go see baseball tonight.
Yeah.
Let's just go to Red Lobster. Let's go to Red Lobster and get surf and turf. Forget this.
I just came back. Quick question. About those Cubs. I was reading an article saying that they're as great, they think they could be as great as the Mets and Yankees. What do you guys think? And wait, who's the Shadow One guy? Is that your friend as well?
No.
I thought that might be Shaz.
It is?
It is?
I think that is Shaz. Is that Shaz?
Well, he's always playing Hearthstone. But I don't know that for sure. That's just my guessing.
Hey, Shaz, turn on your shit.
Did you just dump a whole bunch of steam clothes in fucking the war zone?
Yeah.
Yo, what? Yo, damn. What a heads up.
I don't know why I do crap like that, but it's just kind of fun sometimes.
Hey, man, I'm crazy.
If only you had your fucking, your shit, dude. Yeah, what, have you turned your surface in for repair? I'm not gonna lie, dude, there's gonna be some pissed off people when they get in here. I'm gonna get all the good shit. I already got that one.
Yo, leave the dead island. Hold on.
I already got that one.
Yeah, that one. Well, if you touch a dead island, I'm fucking broke, bro.
Pretty good. X-Blades, already got that one. Renaissance.
Because I could play Dead Island on this game. Oh, and I could find
send them all to Tony. Blue Hero DX.
You guys gotta add me on Steam too. I forgot. We tried to do that back in the day, but
yeah,
I ain't got enough time, but I'm good. So
I put that stuff in there like a few hours ago. So
oh shit,
it may have already been picked over.
No, they're not. I'm stealing a bunch of them, but besides me, no.
Yo,
one
nah, leave that Dead Island, yo. I'm dead ass.
I have Dead Island on PC. Right, I've got both of them, I believe.
Which one is... Wait.
Get them both. Okay. There's Riptide and there's Dead Island Game of the Year Edition.
I was too lazy to put them in alphabetical order or anything.
Killer's dead. You can't have that, dude. I'm taking that shit.
That's that... Nah, you good. That's that... Wait. That's that cartoon shit, right? Cartoon,
yeah, that's the Suda 51. Where everybody talks ridiculous and they kill each other with swords. That's all those games are about.
It's like... A play on Phallus.
I guess it's that's what's going on in his head is people kill each other with swords.
Well, you know, yeah, so, wait, did you? Isn't there a Humble Bundle going on right now?
I think so. I don't know.
I got a Humble Bundle.
Most of this is older stuff, though. It's been up, built up for a while.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. You got the PC gamers, you got the fucking mad old games and shit. You probably get the same game mad times. Different bundles and shit.
Some of it's kind of art games, and some of it's just pure shit games that I don't even know what the fuck
they're... Saints Row the Fourth.
Yeah.
Yeah. A Boy in His Blob is pretty good. Towerfall Ascension.
Hold on. Steam. Make sure we get Steam.
I think I have Toy Soldiers Complete on there, which isn't complete because it doesn't have Toy Soldiers 3, but it has Toy Soldiers 1 and 2.
It's an old complete.
Yeah. No longer complete. Totally cut. That Iron Sky Invasion is that stupid movie about Nazis with flying saucers. It's a game based on that, which probably can't be good. Mm. And Betrayer is like a weird, I don't know, first person shooter that's in black and white.
You have to get fucking Sam and Max. Sam and Max is great. Strong Bad. Oh my god, Strong Bad! I owned that already, though. So, Shadowrun Returns.
It's one of them. I don't.
I won't lie, dude. End of the Line. That's great. Oh, I was hoping for more Star Wars.
I kept the good stuff in Star Wars, like X-Wing Alliance and shit. And the pinball tables. But I was like Jedi Knight 2. Dark Forces. They had their time, but Battlefront 2 is fun if you want to run around shooting Wookiees with a clone trooper.
Sounds boring to me.
Adam's Venture is kind of
Yeah, that's probably not good.
That's
like Bible. Yeah, but that's like a Bible history game or something like that.
Has lots of good stories they can tell.
Sure, but it's a guy who's like looking for some biblical thing and whatever. Frankly, I want video games of people who shoot Blu-rays at each other.
Dude, I wouldn't mind playing some biblical fucking games. I want to play as the Jews when they fucking destroyed fucking all their enemies.
Like Midian and the Aramites?
Yeah. Because they didn't just walk around a goddamn city. What was it?
No, they conquered some of the cities, yeah, but they exterminated some of them, though.
They made examples of cities.
They killed everyone in Jericho except for the women and sold the women into slavery.
Fucking made examples. They were horrible people. Dude. City of Fools. Drakensang is good, but it does... I already own it. Deadly Sin 2.
I don't even know what that is.
I think... I don't know, dude.
I liked Puzzle Agent myself, but nobody I've ever tried to turn on to Puzzle Agent has liked it, so I guess it's just me.
Where the fuck do you put your Steam code
at? They're just from bundles that I bought over, a year. Like this year so far, like I started probably like in January on to about now. These are the leftover codes.
No, I mean, where do you insert the code then?
In Steam.
In the corner it says add a game under the library.
Top right, top left. Oh, okay. Under the library. Like...
But how do you do it in big picture mode? Oh, sorry.
Big picture mode.
I can't do anything in big picture mode.
Yeah, I wouldn't disrespect Steam like that.
Dusty Revenge? What the fuck is that?
I think I have I think that's a thing where there's a rabbit that fights guys or some shit. Like anthropomorphic rabbit fights people.
Kidnapped, I think I got.
I got Risen and Risen 2 in there if you want janky
shit, I got
half-assed Morrowind shit.
I have Risen 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
And I have the games that came before them. Risen was like they made after they lost the rights to their game.
Yeah.
They're actually pretty good games if you like
the first two. The first two were good games. Everyone after that was shit. Yeah. And then the people who had those games, they went on to make Arcania or something like that. That was their continuation.
Human Resource Machine. Back to the Future and Sam Max. I don't know. Do you know who Strong Bad is? Do you know who Strong Bad is?
No, who not?
You go to homestarrunner.com.
Oh, wait, hold on. Let me deal with this first. Who's that? What's that about? Playing yourself. Playing yourself. Playing yourself, nigga. What's that? I ain't going here yet.
This is Strong Bad.
Strong Bad. I'm lost.
HomestarRunner.com.
I'm not going. Well, that's it.
The show is over. There won't be no sequels. It's all on fire. It's all gone to hell. The show is over. And it's all gone to hell. It's hell.
There's only one reason to go to homestarrunner.com. It's to look at fucking Strong Bad emails.
Yeah.
It's stuck on pay, and okay. You can't stop me when we join forces with the School of Bertones.
I put Trogdor on there if anybody.
Yeah, Trogdor is great.
The S is for sucks.
Yes, it's for sucks. More different V's.
Yeah. Constabular V's.
This shit is hilarious. I wish they would keep on doing it, but he kind of, like, doesn't do anything anymore, does he? He releases, like, a Strong Bad email once a year or something.
Yeah. I think he said that his brother isn't around to do the voices, the weird voices anymore.
Here I go once again with the email. Every week, I hope that it's from a female. Oh, man. It's not from a female.
They're all supposed to be wrestling characters,
by the way. Can you draw a dragon?
Like, yeah.
I want to see your skills of an artist.
Like, Homestar Runner was a face, and Strong Bad was
G2G,
a heel.
Guys are from
but the weird thing about Strong Bad, he looks like a wrestler,
Dragon.
But he's
a
doing his costume right now. His
Feel
actual
free
wrestling thing is like,
along with
I am the mapologist, or
I'm
something like that, you know? He's always like, the cartographer!
For Snake.
It's he'll put that over his wrestling costume
Next,
and pretend that he's
we'll
like an explorer cartographer. And that's what he's doing for wrestling.
Head, put a top mark on a long V. Then you add some legs, throw on a couple of arms, and whoa, wait a minute, I think I need to start over. This thing doesn't look natural. Okay, starting again, the same way, S or different S. Close it up real good at the top for his head, and then, using consummate V's, give him teeth, spinities, and angry eyebrows. Now you can add smoke or fire, or maybe some wings. You know, if he's a wingling dragon.
A wingling dragon.
Let's put one of those beefy arms back on him for good measure. That looks really good.
Yeah.
Coming out of the back of his neck there. Now he needs
he's
a name.
Talking about the
How about Trogdor the Burninator?
He has an arm coming out the back of his neck.
Oh, yeah. Check out all his
to
majesty.
Come in handy.
There's my dragon, Kaiser. Let's see how the other students are doing.
The other students.
Yeah.
All right.
Most of them are way better than me.
Take a look there. I think she's looking pretty good.
I said consummate, V's. Consummate! Jeez. Guy with no majesty ever came up and bit him in the face.
It happened once.
Strong man.
Happened once.
Keep doing your thing, man. Get out of my house.
I do what I'm told.
Oh, crap. I didn't know you were doing one.
Oh, sure. I think I've improved on your methods a bit, too. I employed some chiaroscuro shading and...
I'll improve on your methods!
What?
I don't know, I was too old for
him. That's not an improvement.
I'd be like Menudo.
Trogdor strikes again!
I'm old as shit. Well, that was the Backstreet Boys in NSYNC when I was a little kid.
All your talking was covered up by Trogdor that whole time. I paused, I didn't let the song go.
I got two.
You don't know it, but you're here for me. He's right.
One for the plug, one for the hose.
Look at me. No, look at me.
Man, I gotta go run. I'm no fucking.
Gee, take this gum that I owe to the poop smith.
To the poop smith. Remember when he talked for one time?
No, I never saw him talk.
He talked one time.
Question.
I just remember they suggested that the poop smith existed to save them all from the king's poop. that it was the king's poop. There's a reason it would have covered everything if it wasn't for the poop smith.
Yo, did you have beat Doom Raid yet?
I haven't beat it.
The new one?
No, I haven't beat it.
All right, so no. Oh fuck! No. I was gonna ask you guys. I'm not close.
You're over here like wanting to play the. Talk about fucking Tomb Raider. I'm gonna end this show.
Okay.
Yo, why is this shit not ended, motherfucker?
I don't know, dude.
Omega, the end!
Yes. So I want to thank all of our listeners. If you want to help us get back onto the audio podcast, you can support us at patreon.com/fanzone. We need $30 a month in order to get up and running back onto the audio podcast, so you can get all your audio delicious podcasts delivered to you on a daily or weekly basis. And anything more than that will go right back to the fans, either through giveaways or equipment for us. And by equipment, I mean new mics, audio, better audio devices for
scuba
recording.
Flippers.
Yeah, scuba flippers, whores, coke.
Fuck that. You gotta get fucking internet for
that's sexist, man. Money. Whores are people.
Whores are people too. Gold digging whores. Bill Burr, gold digging whores. Look it up. All right, thanks everybody.
I know that motherfucker. I know that.